and today is Tuesday, May 7th. Let's get started with today's announcements. First off, we would like to congratulate the boys Clayton and Michael Edwards, Ethan Dean, and Franklin Scott in the 4x4 100-meter relay state championship on Maui this past Saturday. Way to go, Rams!
The 4x4 Radford. Tell me, how does it feel? What was going through your mind?
I was barely thinking of anything. It just all happened at once. I'm just so thankful that the coaches prepared us so well. I don't think I could ever do it without them. Yeah, my goal that whole race was to either get a lead or hold on to the last 100. That was my big race plan, was just pass the 100. And it worked beautifully, just as the coaches told me it would.
Wow, awesome. What about you?
I owe it all to my coaches. They helped me with everything. I just didn't want to let my team down because they got me here.
Awesome, you guys. And what about you? What were your feelings in that race?
So painful. But we did it as a team. We've been working hard all day in practice. So this is nothing new. We just had to execute the race. And we did it. It's hard work. It's a blessing.
It looked good. That hard work pays off, and you guys are looking fantastic out there. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And that's it. But we also have lunch. So for lunch, we have popcorn chicken, whipped potatoes, steamed corn, steamed carrots, fruit of the day. And for you lactose intolerant people, we've got milk. That's all for Rampage TV. I'm Akira.
And I'm Elaina.
I hope you have a ramtastic day.
Hi, I'm Carl Azus, delivering your May 7th edition of CNN 10. Thank you for taking the time to watch our show. Last night, it looked like a ceasefire was taking hold in the Middle East. It came after a weekend of violence between Israel and Palestinian militant groups. In fact, this was the worst fighting between the two sides since war broke out in 2014. It all started Friday in Gaza, a Palestinian-controlled territory of about 2 million people that borders the Mediterranean Sea. During weekly protests near the fence between Gaza and Israel, a sniper inside Gaza wounded two Israeli soldiers, and Israel's military killed four Palestinians. The violence got worse throughout the weekend, and by Monday, Hamas and Islamic Jihad, two Palestinian militant groups, had fired 690 rockets into Israel, according to the nation's military. And Israel had launched airstrikes against 350 militant targets. At least four people in Israel were killed, at least 23 people were killed in Gaza, and the two sides blamed each other for the attacks. The Israeli president said his nation would continue its, quote, massive attacks against terrorist elements, and that Hamas was responsible and would pay a heavy price. The leader of Hamas in Gaza said, quote, the more atrocious the Israeli attacks on the Palestinian civilians are, the stronger the Palestinian response will be. After intense diplomatic work by the United Nations and Egypt to get the two sides to stop fighting, it appeared that things had calmed down on Monday, though the leaders of Israel and Hamas were saying more attacks could be on the horizon. The United Nations specifically spoke out against the launches of rockets into civilian areas of Israel. When that happens, Israel has what's called an Iron Dome defense system in place.
So how does this thing work? Three key phases to think about. The first one is detection. Anytime rockets launch headed toward Israel, very high-tech cameras, radar systems, and computers start analyzing them. How big are they? How fast are they moving? Importantly, where are they pointed? Because at the same time, the analysis and targeting phase is triggered. What that means is If it sees that some of these are headed off into the water or perhaps headed into rural areas where there's really not much to hit, they just let them go. The whole system says, we're done with you. Go off and explode. You'll make no difference to anyone. But if it spots a missile out there that's aimed toward a building or a town or places where people can get hurt, then those same computers kick into the destruction phase. That means that they communicate with batteries of missiles on the ground, and they fire those. And those fly up and get as close as they can to that incoming threat. Each of these defensive missiles may be only about 10 feet long, but has some 24 pounds of high explosives. And when they're close enough, they detonate, obliterating everything in that part of the sky. Can we get